Hello dear learners, and today again I'm here with set of MCQs based on the poem The Voice of the Rain. And these MCQs are very important for you all for your forthcoming examination. So without further ado, let us begin our set of MCQs on the poem The Voice of the Rain. Number one, what does the word Latin in the text mean? So in the text we find this word latent, right? So what does it mean? Options: hidden, exposed. So the correct option for this would be your option number A, that is hidden. Okay, latent means what? Hidden. Next question, question number two, the word impalpable in the text means option A, something that cannot be touched, option B, something that can be touched. So the correct option for this would be your option number A, that is something that can be touched. Okay, option number A, impalpable, right? So question number three, what does it say? It says, from where does the rain originate, right? So the options are vast land and deep sea, option B, vast valleys. So the correct option for this would be your option number A, that is vast land and deep sea. Question number four, okay. The word thou in the text means options are you, option number B, your. So the correct option for this would be your option number A, that is you. That is thou means you. Okay, thou is an old English word, okay, and these days, I mean in the modern day world, we don't use it, so it has almost become, you know, archaic now, right? Question number five, I'm the poem of earth, identify the poetic device. So the poetic device you got to identify. So what is it? Options are personification, option B, simile. So the correct option would be your option number A, that is personification, right? So personification is a figure of speech in which inanimate objects, okay, are given the attribute of, you know, living being, right? For example, I have given you an example of listening to the story, the chalk started crying. So chalk basically cannot cry, isn't it? But we are making it cry. That means we are giving it attribute of a human being. So in this case, the figure of speech would be personification. And in the poem, the poet has personified rain. Don't forget this. Question number six, how many voices are there in the poem? Option A, two, option B, three. So the correct option for this would be option number A, that is two voices. One of the poet and the other of the rain, right? So two voices are there, one of the poet and the other of the rain. Okay, question number seven, what does it say? Das is the poet of the poem The Voice of the Rain. So in the examination it is often asked, so you got to remember the name of the poem, I mean the poet, right? And the options are John Keats, option number B, Walt Whitman. So the correct option for this would be your option number B, that is Walt Whitman. And Walt Whitman was an American poet, remember? Very important American poet. Question number eight, the word lave in the text means option A, wash, option B, make pure. So the correct option for this would be your option number A, that is wash, right? Question number nine, the poem contains a parallel between rain and, that means the poet, you know, in the poem has compared this rain with, options are music, option B, poem. So the correct option is option number A, that is music. And the last question, it says the opposite word for rise is, options are descent, option B, wrecked. So the correct option would be, opposite word of rise would be descent, right? So these are 10 important MCQs, right, based on your poem, The Voice of the Rain, written by Walt Whitman. Thank you and happy learning.